بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Since we are all staying home these days because of coronavirus, I thought to discuss an interesting topic with you that has some calculation, just to do some brainstorming and to keep us busy. And this topic, actually, infant nutrition. I have been asked for several times, but today I will only do some spotlights on infant nutrition, specifically total parental nutrition and how to calculate the calories and what are the caloric requirements for babies and so on. This topic today is good for whoever is applying or sitting for the neonatal board, whichever that board, American board or Arab board, and so on. But it also might help you in your clinical practice. I know during our clinical practice, those who have clinical pharmacist, usually they do the calculation for the total parental nutrition for them. But it's also very important for us neonatologists to understand how to do the calories and what are the caloric requirements and what are the recent recommendations for optimal growth and so on. So this topic today will cover these aspects. And this talk today will also fall under the academic track, and I will remind you with six tracks that I cover in my YouTube channel. And by the way, if you would like to subscribe to my YouTube channel, all what you're going to do is you're just going to type my name, which is written here on the bottom of the slide, in the YouTube search engine, and then you can subscribe to it and you will find all my lectures there. Another reminder I'd like to remind you is the six tracks I cover in my YouTube channel, starting from the academic track, clinical track, hands-on skills, research track, quality improvement, evidence-based medicine. And these are most of the lectures I will place on my YouTube channel will fall under one of these tracks. And today's lecture, as I said, will fall under the academic track. And let's start our talk today with this scenario. This is a very common scenario that we all might face in our daily practice in the neonatal ICU. You have a 1.5 kilogram infant, baby's on total fluid of 150 ml per kilogram per day. The baby is nil by mouth and is receiving total parental nutrition with D10W. Baby also receiving 3 grams per kilogram per day of lipids, 20%. This is a concentration of lipids. And also receiving 3.5 grams per kilogram per day amino acids of 10% solution. This is also the concentration of the amino acid solution the baby is receiving. And the question says, which of the following is correct? Around 30 ml of lipids, 20%, is needed to provide the fat requirements for this baby, or the caloric intake for this baby is sufficient for optimal growth, or the glucose intake rate, GIR, is 7.9 mg per kilogram per minute, or the protein intake is providing 1 gram of nitrogen. Most of the calories are from the carbohydrates and lipids. I will advise you at this point to stop or to pause this lecture and try to go through the calculation and think about the right answer for this question before we go through it together until the end of this lecture. Okay, now after you did your calculation, let's go through the answers one by one. Answer 8 says around 30 ml of the lipids, 20%, is needed to provide the fat requirements for this baby. Let's see, the question says that the baby is receiving 3 gram per kilogram. So since the baby is 1.5 kilogram, so the baby will need 4.5 gram of lipids per day. Since the baby is receiving lipid 20%, it means that each 100 ml of the solution contains 20 gram of lipids. So if you do simple math, if 100 ml provide 20 gram, how many ml needed to provide 4.5 gram? And the answer for this simply will be that you need 22.5 ml of lipid 20% to provide the baby with a 4.5 gram per day. So this answer is not correct. The baby need only 22.5 ml and not needing 30 ml. And roughly without any calculation, each 5 ml per kilo of lipid 20% will provide 1 gram of lipids per day. So if the baby needs 3 grams, then you multiply 15 ml times the body weight, and this will give you the 3 gram per day of lipids. This is just without any calculation. Okay, let's go through answer B. And answer B says, is the caloric intake sufficient for optimal growth? And before we answer this question, obviously we need to know what are the recommendations for caloric intake for preterm babies to provide optimal growth. And the recommendation says that if the baby is receiving the nutrition enterally, the baby needs between 100 and 130 kilocalories per kilogram per day. The SPGAN have a little bit higher recommendation, so they provide 115 to 130 kilocalories per kilogram per day. But if the baby is receiving the nutrition parenterally, so the baby will need only 85 to 95 kilocalories per kilogram per day. And one would ask here, why is the difference? And the difference is because the enteral feeding need digestion and absorption and so on, and this will take some or consume some of the calories which not needed for the parenteral nutrition. Now let's see how many calorie the baby is receiving, or what are the form of calories the baby is receiving. So the baby is receiving carbohydrate, lipids, and proteins, and we should know how many calorie each gram of this form of calories is providing. So we have to know that the carbohydrates provide, each 1 gram of carbohydrates provide 3.4 calorie. Each gram of lipids provide 9 kilocalorie, and each gram of proteins will provide 4 kilocalorie. Now let's go through the calculation of calories. We said that 1 gram of proteins provide 4 kilocalories, and since the baby is receiving 3.5 gram per kilo, so the baby will be receiving 14 kilocalorie per kilogram per day of proteins. Lipids providing 1 gram will provide 9 kilocalorie, and since the baby is receiving 3 gram per kilo, so the baby will be receiving 27 kilocalorie per kilogram per day from lipids. Now the question would be how many kilocalorie the baby is receiving from carbohydrates, and this is will be a bit complicated because before we can calculate the calories the baby is receiving from carbohydrates in the form of the glucose D10W the baby is receiving, we have to answer this question: how many ml of D10W is the baby receiving per day? And this will need some more calculation. So before we can calculate or know the answer for this question, how many ml the baby is receiving in the form of D10W, we have first to subtract the ml of the amino acid solution and of lipids the baby is receiving. So how are we going to do this? Let's go through this calculation first. For the amino acid, we said the baby is receiving 3.5 gram per kilo, and since the baby is 1.5 kilogram, then the baby is receiving 5.25 gram per day. Since the baby is receiving amino acid 10%, so each 100 ml will provide 10 grams. And again, as we did with before with the lipid, if 100 ml is providing 10 gram, how many ml will provide 5.25 grams? So the answer for this question will be the baby needs 52.5 ml of amino acid 10% to provide the 5.25 grams the baby needing. Lipids, we already went through it, but we can repeat here again. They said the baby needs 3 gram per kilo, so the 3 gram multiplied by 1.5, this will be 4.5 gram. Since the baby is receiving lipid 20%, so each 100 ml will provide 20 gram. By doing simple math, if 100 ml provide 20 gram, how many ml provide 4.5 gram? And the answer for this will be 22.5 ml of lipid. This is what we calculated before. Now if you add the 52.5 plus the 22.5, so to provide these amino acid and lipids, the baby will need 70. Now let's calculate the ml and the calories of carbohydrates. And to remind you, we said already that proteins providing 14 kilocalorie per kilogram per day, and the lipids providing 27 kilocalorie per kilogram per day. And to calculate the carbohydrates, first we have to calculate how many ml the baby is receiving per day. And the question says that the baby is receiving 150 ml per kilo per day, and the baby is 1.5 kilo, so the baby is receiving 225 ml per day of D10W. You have to subtract the 75 ml the baby is receiving for the amino acid and the lipids, and this will left the baby with only 150 ml of the D10W. And by the way, you will also, if the baby is receiving medications and infusions or whatever, you also you have subtracted from the total fluid. But since the question did not mention this, here we will only subtract amino acid and lipids. Now the question says the baby is D10W, means that each 100 ml of the D10W contain 10 gram of sugar. So the 150 will provide 15 gram of sugar. We said that each gram of sugar provides 3.4 kilocalorie. So this will be 51 kilocalorie divided by the body weight will be 1.5, which is 1.5 kilogram. So the answer will be 34 kilocalorie per kilogram per day. Let's add all these calories together, 14 kilocalorie of proteins, 27 kilocalorie per kilo of lipids, plus 34 kilocalorie per kilo of carbohydrates. So the baby is receiving 75 kilocalorie per kilogram per day. And the question says, is this caloric intake is sufficient for optimal growth? And the answer is no, because we said that the baby is in total parental nutrition, baby need between 85 and 95 kilocalorie per kilogram per day, and the baby is receiving less this than this recommendation for optimal growth. So that answer also is not correct. Now let's go through answer C. Is the glucose intake rate, the GIR, is 7.9 milligram per kilogram per minute. Now let's calculate the GIR. And there are many ways actually available to calculate the GIR, but for me, this is the simplest and the easiest to remember. So now let's calculate by this way. The GIR equal the fluid rate per hour multiplied by the strength of the fluid, mean D10W or D20 and so on, divided by body weight multiplied by 6, body weight in kilogram. So the fluid rate, the baby, we said the baby receiving 150 ml per day. So 150 divided by 24 hour, so the rate or the hourly rate is 6.25 multiplied by 10 because the baby is receiving D10W divided by 1.5 times 6. So the answer here will be 6.9 milligram per kilogram per minute. This is the GIR, so it's not 7.9. It's baby is receiving only 6.9 milligram per kilogram per minute. So this answer also is not correct. Now let's go through answer D. The protein intake is providing 1 gram of nitrogen. And in order to calculate this, we have to know that each gram of protein provides only 0.16 gram of nitrogen. So that in other words, the baby, each 6.25 grams of proteins will provide 1 gram of nitrogen. We said the baby protein intake is 3.5 times 1.5 kilograms. So the baby is receiving 5.25 gram per day only. So the nitrogen intake here will be 5.25 multiplied by 0.16, so it will be 0.84 gram of nitrogen and not 1. So this answer also is not correct. Now let's go through the last answer. Most of the calories are from carbohydrate and lipids, and this is same. We did all this calculation before, and look here and in the bottom line in the total calories, we said 14. Kilocalorie per kilogram per day from proteins, 27 kilocalorie per kilogram per day from lipids, and 34 kilocalorie per kilogram per day of carbohydrates. So if you add the lipids and the carbohydrates together, this will be actually most of the calories are coming from lipids and carbohydrates. So this was our scenario, and these were the answers, and the correct answer is E. Most of the calories are from carbohydrates and lipids, and I will leave you here, and I hope that this was beneficial for you, and I hope it will help you to answer similar questions in your board, and I hope also it will reflect in your clinical practice and will help you to provide good caloric intake for optimal growth of our preterm babies population. And thank you, and I will leave you here.